This is Barry's seat. Barry usually never misses a game, whether it be here at Anfield, at home with his family, or at his friend's house.
I remember this. It was a really important game, and I scored a beautiful goal. The public was really loud, but unfortunately, Barry wasn't at the stadium.
Yeah, I remember it well. He turns around and goes like this. I wish Barry had been there to see that.
Yeah, he hadn't been there for a long time.
Mo gave me a perfect assist and I only had to put it in, and yeah, then you could just celebrate with the whole stadium. But one of the members was missing, and this was Barry.
I definitely think he was making excuses. You know, was he lying? I don't know, but was he making excuses?
There was always a reason. There was always a different reason as well. He was getting inventive with his reasons.
I will never forget this first time when I entered in Anfield. The first 5 minutes, I forget the game. I just watch around me. I heard everyone in the stadium. But on this day, Barry was not here.
In the last 3 to 4 years, I got to the point where if Liverpool won or Liverpool lost, it didn't have any relevance on my life, or it just didn't feel anything. Depression, it just clouds over everything. And one of them things was Liverpool Football Club. The first time I went back to Anfield, I was apprehensive in some ways because I was going back to something that I loved so much, and then I'd stopped loving it. Would I still love it the same as I did?
Hey, Baz,
oh,
you doing, mate?
All right. Good. Yeah, good. Yeah.
Great to see you back.
Well done. Glad to be back. Really, and
you? Good to see you, mate. I see it's been MC for too long, you know.
I just can't wait for the kickoff. You know how much I love Liverpool and love going to the game.
We missed you, but you know what? We're not the only ones who missed you.
You want that hug again? Yeah.
Oh,
yes.
Nice to meet you.
So, Barry, can you tell us what happened to you?
Yeah, probably over the last couple of years, my mental health struggles just came to the top, and it's just struggling in generally. I was depressed, I was down. I was anxious, anxiety, but it came to the point where it was then affecting my life. I was going to lose my wife. And then you'd have to think, let's stop, let's get back, and then let's think how I can be back to the person I was. But now, thankfully, I'm in a good place, yeah.
But how did you do it to get better? What did you do?
The first thing I'd done is I went to a local charity called Flourish and Succeed, and just speaking to people about how I felt, just the power of conversation, the power of talk.
The first thing to do is to talk.
Yeah. To talk, you've got to talk to your friend,
to your family.
Yeah. Of course.
For me, injuries or something, you don't play good. And my wife, my family knows how to really catch me up, and I'm really grateful for this. And yeah.
Yes, I think this can happen to everybody. Sometimes it's hard to see what happened with your friend or a family member. Last year, We lost my father, so we tried to be this support for my mother. For different situations, people struggle in their life, so I think it's important to be in contact with the people that you love.
Yeah. It's just being about supporting each other, and it's being honest with yourself, and then...
Well, that's the hardest stuff.
Yeah, that's the hardest stuff.
The biggest part, isn't it? Yeah. I wish I'd seen the signs a little bit sooner, but if that seat did go empty again, it wouldn't be 2 or 3 weeks down the line where I'd send a text, I'd knock on the door now.
Yeah. It's just a slow change.
Yeah.
I just look at life differently now. Every day I'm thankful, you know, that. I mean, I'm standing here now, I'm talking to you guys. If somebody would have said that to me 18 months ago, I never would have believed that.
Thank you, Barry, to share your story with us. Welcome back. And if you need help, we are here for you.
Thank you.
And yes, I hope your seat will never be empty again.
Take that. Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you to the next game.
One of the big things that you do is you check in with each other. You just send that text message, is everything okay? You know, you might be on the bus, you might be at the bus stop, you might see somebody every morning. They're not there on a particular day. Why aren't they there? Are they okay? Just that little message to somebody. I didn't see you last week. Is everything okay? It makes a hell of a difference to somebody, because somebody thinks that you actually care.
An empty seat can be full of meaning. If you know somebody who is no longer watching the games with you, make sure you check in on them.